are going to be talking Mystery on Monster Island, which is a 1981 movie directed by Juan Piquet Simon. And this was actually a Jules Verne story and stars Peter Cushing, Terence Stamp and Paul Naschke. So this is a movie where I am going to have to discuss spoilers, because this movie is famous for having a very big plot twist. And I currently, it's nearly 40 years old, so if you haven't seen this by now, I'm going to spoil it for you. Anyway, so let's discuss what the movie's about. It focuses on this rich guy, played by Peter Cushing. He buys this private island, essentially. And he's kind of being bid against by this other guy, played by Terence Stamp. And Terence Stamp's character knows this island is rich with gold. And Peter Cushing has got this nephew that wants to kind of live this life of adventure, and he kind of doesn't want to take over Peter Cushing's company. So he goes, basically goes across to kind of like curate this kind of island. And on the way there, the boat is attacked by kind of some kind of like mer-men. And him and this kind of professor that's kind of his, I guess you would call it teacher, end up stranded on this island that they come across various characters and misadventures, lots of kind of different monsters and stuff like that, and we discover a shocking twist at the end of this movie. So let's discuss Mystery on Monster Island. And I don't mind telling you, when I was a young boy, this was one of my favourite movies. I used to rent it loads of different times on VHS because I loved it. And does it hold up by today? Well, no, if we're being completely honest. Let's go through the kind of the positives and negatives, and we'll touch on kind of some of the plot details whilst we go through it. First thing, if you're a fan of the kind of the old school Doctor Who TV shows, and I'm talking the kind of the 70s and the 80s ones, this film is very reminiscent of that kind of era of kind of special effects, the kind of the monsters and the kind of the creature effects and the, you know, the animatronics here are very much of that ilk. So if you kind of like low budget kind of monster effects, people in rubber suits, that kind of thing, then you may want to check it out. And the leading guy here, kind of our main character, this nephew, let me tell you, he's no Doug McClure. A very kind of weak leading man who, you know, he just doesn't really have any kind of charisma. One of the most annoying things about this movie is the kind of this kind of side character of this professor, architect or something. He's called something similar to that. And my God, the guy just shrieks through the whole film. Now, this is a kind of a kid's film, and there's kind of like, you have these kind of pratfalls followed by kind of like funny p-doings kind of sounds and that sort of thing. But nonetheless, this guy's just completely kind of OTT. The acting here from both him, massively OTT, and the kind of our lead character, this kind of this nephew, who just isn't very kind of interesting, to be quite honest, doesn't make for a great kind of pair of kind of leading characters. I mean, this movie does kind of, like I said, it stars Terence Stamp, kind of Peter Cushing, but they ain't really any kind of top and tail this movie. It's really just a kind of a cameo. So don't be expecting kind of a movie with lots of them in it. So the acting isn't particularly good. When you are aware of the plot, now that this is where I'm going to go into a spoiler, it turns out that the whole point of this movie is has just been a big, basically, fake-out. The uncle has hired actors and animatronic people in kind of like monster suits and pyrotechnics to simulate a kind of a monster island, so the nephew will feel like he, you know, has had an adventure, basically. So, when you start to think about it, and obviously this is the days before kind of mobile communications and stuff, it doesn't make sense because there's no way that anyone would have time to kind of like orchestrate anything on such a large scale in the kind of the period of time and the money that it would cost. And we never really know why Peter Cushing's character buys the island in the first place. We know why Terence Stamp wants it, because he wants the kind of the gold, but we're never really given any kind of motivation about why Peter Cushing's character is interested in the island to begin with, or why he's sending his nephew there, really, or at least his kind of why, you know, the nephew thinks he's being sent there. So it's kind of a whole bunch of silly. The movie, by this today's standards as well, borders on being somewhat kind of racially offensive by some of the kind of the stereotypes you might see from certain kind of ethnicities, shall we say. When we come down to it, it is kind of just a bunch of silly kind of scenes. I mean, we have a genuine threat. I will say that. There is a kind of a genuine threat of kind of Terrence Stamp and his kind of crew of kind of mercenaries. And we have a ridiculous action sequences where they are kind of our heroes, and we get a couple of kind of additional characters join them along the way. But they're fighting off this kind of band of bandits and built this amazing fort in seemingly no time without any resources, and with cannons that shoot out loads of bananas and things like that. And no one questions it. It's just a very silly film, to be quite honest. Like I said, I think this movie is for kids, and I think for kids of the era of 1981, they may well have enjoyed it because they kind of won't question things. But I feel even kids this day and age will kind of see the silliness of it, if I'm completely honest. What I do like in it, even though some of the kind of the monster effects look a bit crappy, they're still kind of fun. We have this one scene, and it's not a long scene, and this is the one that always stood out to me, where we have our heroes, if you like, running away from these kind of giant monsters. And it looks alright. I mean, they kind of look clearly fake, but they look quite good. And it looks like they spent quite a lot of money on these big suits and stuff. It looks, I kind of like that. But the sequences are very short. And then we have this sequence in this cage, there's caterpillar monsters in it. So they kind of look alright. But it's just a very short sequence. Probably the best sequence, I would say, and probably the one that maybe is the most scary, we're talking from a kid's film, but nonetheless, is when we kind of go on the shore and these kind of like sea monsters come out, all dressed up like in seaweed and stuff like that. They're kind of like zombies. That's quite good, but you know, when you kind of look at realistically, okay, these are meant to be all actors, what are they doing? Are they hiding underneath the waves and stuff, ready to kind of come out, just on the off chance that these people are going to come round to this particular area? It's really silly. It really is. You know, this is kind of one of the early twist movies, I guess you want to say. And it's kind of fun in a cheesy way. But this movie is so kind of like, it spends so much time with the camera focus on the kind of the wildlife. The music is kind of very distracting and has this kind of like, upbeat kind of, very British sounding kind of like adventure music. I don't know, it didn't suit it a lot of the time. Peter Cushing and Terrence Stamp are great when they're on screen, but like I've said, they're on it very kind of a small amount, so don't be too excited. But if you'd like the kind of like the journey to the centre of the Earth, at the Earth's core, those type of movies, this is essentially a kind of a lesser cousin to those type of movies. It's certainly one that you can skip. I don't really feel it holds up and is really held in any kind of reverence. And this is talking about someone who loved it when they were a child as well, but it really kind of isn't very good when push comes to shove. But it has a certain charm. I can't help but feel it does have a kind of a certain cheesy charm to it. So I don't feel like I'd be too mean on it. So I am going to give this movie a 4 out of 10. It isn't very good. You know, let's call it a spade. But it does have some weird retro kind of charm if you do like the kind of the monster movies as well. But it won't hold up to the kind of like Land of Time Forgot, things like that. So 4 out of 10. Have you seen it? What did you think of it? Leave me a comment. And I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye for now.